WowMath, in this video, we will represent quadratic function through table of values and graphs. So, our objective represents a quadratic function using table of values and graphs. So, first, complete the following table of values using the indicated function. So, all you have to do is to substitute the given values of x from negative 3 to positive 3 for us to get the values of y. So, ito rin yung tinatawag nating evaluate. So, we will evaluate the given function using the values of y. So, first, we have, using the values of x rather. So, isa-substitute natin lahat ng values of x for us to get the values of y. So, ito, I have 2x plus 1 since that is our given. So, we will just substitute negative 3 sa x variable. So, 2 times negative 3, that is negative 6 plus 1, that is negative 5. So, ilalagay natin dito, negative 5. Next, negative 2. So, we will substitute negative 2 dun sa ating x. So, this is negative 4 plus 1, that is negative 3. So, we will put negative 3. Next, we have negative 1. So, 2 times negative 1, that is negative 2 plus 1. So, we have negative 1. For 0, we have 2 times 0. So, therefore, ang matitira na lang ay yung constant natin. Kasi any number na i-multiply natin by 0, the answer is always 0. It has no value. So, ang maiiwan na lang ay yung constant, which is 1. And then, for 1, so let us substitute positive 1, so that is 2 plus 1, that is positive 3. For positive 2, substitute positive 2 to the variable x, so that is positive 4 plus 1, that is positive 5. And then, for the last values of x, we have positive 3, so 2 times 3, that is 6 plus 1, that is positive 7. So, here's our table of values. From the given assigned values doon sa ating x. So, we have negative 3, negative 5, negative 2, negative 3, negative 1, negative 1, 0, 1, 1, 3, 2, 5, and 3, 7. Let's have another. So, evaluate f of x is equal to x squared plus 2x minus 1. So, I have here the values of x from negative 3 to positive 3. So, isa-substitute natin ulit. So, evaluate. Pag sinabi evaluate, mag-ano tayo? Magsa-substitute ng values ng x for us to get the values of y. So, we have first negative 3. Substitute natin si negative 3 doon sa ating mga x variables. So, we have negative 3 squared plus 2 times negative 3 minus 1. So, we have negative 3 squared is 9. This is negative 6 and then negative 1. So, we have 9 minus 6, 3 minus 1. That is positive 2. So, that is positive 2. Next, negative 2. Substitute naman natin si negative 2. So, negative 2 squared plus 2 times negative 2 minus 1. So, negative 2 squared is positive 4. This is negative 4. And then, bring down negative 1. So, that is 4 minus 4, 1. 4 minus 4, 0, minus 1, that is negative 1. So, ilalagay natin dito, negative 1. Next, for negative 1, substitute natin si negative 1 dito sa mga x natin. So, negative 1 squared plus 2 times negative 1 minus 1. So, negative 1 squared, that is 1. 2 times negative 1, that is negative 2, and then negative 1. So, 1 minus 2, that is negative 1 minus 1, that is negative 2. Okay, so kagaya ng sinabi ko kanina, since 0 to at 0 to, ang maiiwan na lang ay yung constant natin na negative 1. Next, so we have positive 1. So substitute natin si positive 1. So 1 squared is positive 1. 2 times 1, that is positive 2 minus 1. So 1 plus 2, 3 minus 1, that is positive 2. Next, we have positive 2. So substitute natin si positive 2. 2 squared plus 2 times 2 minus 1. So, this is 2 squared. That is 4. 2 times 2, that is 4 minus 1. So, 4 plus 4, 8 minus 1. That is 7. So, this is 7. Next, 3. So, this is 3 squared plus 2 times 3 minus 1. So, 3 squared is 9. 2 times 3, that is 6 minus 1. So, 9 plus 6, 15 minus 1. That is positive 14. So, this is positive 14. 14. So this is how we evaluate functions. All you have to do is to substitute all the assigned values for x. Kung ano yung mga values dito ng x, i-substitute lang siya natin. So we can get the values of y in linear function or even in quadratic function. Now, paano natin malalaman na quadratic function siya given ang table of values? So, in a quadratic function, equal differences in the independent variable x produce equal second differences in the dependent variable. So, ano bang ibig sabihin nito? Let us have an example. So, if I have here f of x is equal to x squared minus 2x plus 3. So, meron ako ditong table of values. So, itong x natin, meron ako ditong from negative 3 to positive 3. And then, nakuha ko na yung y. So, we have negative 3, 18, negative 2, 11, negative 1, 6, 0, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, and 3, 6. Okay. Now, kapag ang given natin ay table of values, let's say wala ito. Halimbawa, wala ito. Paano natin malalaman na itong table of values na ito is representing quadratic function? So, kukunin natin yung differences dun sa first difference and then sa second difference natin. So, dun muna tayo, focus tayo sa first difference natin. So, we have 11 minus 18, that is negative 7. So, kapag kumukuha tayo ng difference, ito, yung second term mo, ima-minus mo dun sa previous term. Yung second term mo, ima-minus mo yung previous term mo. So, 11 minus 18, that is negative 7. This is 6 minus 11, that is negative 5. Hindi ito 11 minus 6, ha? 6 minus 11. And then 3 minus 6, that is negative 3. And then 2 minus 3, that is negative 1. 3 minus 2, that is 1. And then 6 minus 3, that is positive 3. So, ulitin ko, pag kumukuha tayo ng difference, pabalik tayo. So, 11 minus 18, 6 minus 11, 3 minus 6, 2 minus 3, 3 minus 2, and 6 minus 3. Now, as you can see, the first difference natin dun sa y ay negative 7, negative 5, negative 3, negative 1, 1, and 3. So, hindi sila equal. Okay? Proceed tayo dun sa second difference. So, yung second difference in y, ima-minus natin siya. Negative 5 minus negative 7. So, magiging negative 5 plus 7 siya. That's why we have the difference of positive 2. So, here, we will have negative 3 minus 5. So, negative 3 minus negative 5. Sorry, hindi ko nabanggit yung negative. So, magiging negative 3 plus 5 siya, kaya positive 2 pa rin. And then, negative 1 minus negative 3. So, that is negative 1 plus 3. That is positive 2. 1 minus negative 1. That is positive 2. 3 minus 1. That is positive 2. So, what have you noticed? They are all equal on the second differences. So, pagdating dun sa second differences natin, nag-equal siya. So, anong ibig sabihin ito? Pag sa second difference natin, nag-equal siya. Ayan, the second differences are equal. Hence, this table represents a quadratic function. Ulitin ko, kapag ang second difference mo ay nag-equal, yan yung pwede nating masabi o mako-consider natin siya as quadratic function kahit hindi natin ito makita. Kasi kapag given ito, madali nating malaman dahil sa degree, di ba? So ngayon, paano kung wala ito? Ang given lang natin ay table of values. So, pwede natin kunin yung first and second difference. Focus tayo sa second difference. Kapag ang second difference natin ay nag-equal, then the table of values represents quadratic function. Now, halimbawa na ang first difference nyo, dun pa lang sa first difference, nag-equal na siya. So, halimbawa, dito pa lang nung after mong kunin ng first difference, they are all equal. That is not a quadratic function. That is just a linear function. So, doon natin masasabi na kapag ang differences niya ay nag-equal doon pa lang sa una, linear function lang siya. Pero pagdating sa second difference, doon siya nag-equal, that is a quadratic function. Always remember that. Next, So I have here 2x squared plus 4x plus 5. So ito yung nag-assign ako ng table of values for x, and then ito yung table values of y. So kunin natin ang first difference. That is negative 6, negative 2, positive 2, positive 6, 19 minus 9, that is 10, 33 minus 19, that is 14. So, dun pa lang sa first difference, they are not equal. But, lagi ko ang sinasabi, pag dito pa lang sa first difference, nag-equal na siya, ibig sabihin, linear function lang yun. Okay? So, let us get the second difference. So, negative 2 minus negative 6, that is positive 4. This is also positive 4, positive 4, positive 4, and positive 4. So, dun sa second difference natin, second differences, equal sila. So, the second differences are equal. Hence, this table represents a quadratic function. So, this is how we can easily determine if the given table of values is a quadratic function. But like what I always say, na kapag nag-equal na sila dito pa lang sa first difference, that is just a linear function. Another example, I have here again x squared plus 2x minus 1. So kung wala ito, paano natin malalaman kung quadratic function siya given lang ang table of values? So we have, kunin ulit natin ang first difference. So ito siya. So hindi siya equal. So kunin natin ang second differences in y. So we have positive 2, positive 2. All of them are positive 2. So, lahat ng difference niya ay positive 2. Now, actually, ito yung given natin kanina sa activity. Itong x squared plus 2x minus 1, ito yung ginamit natin kanina nung nag-evaluate tayo. So, nag-evaluate tayo, nag-try tayo mag-substitute ng values of x. Kinuha natin yung values of y nito kanina. So, ito yung lumabas kanina. If you can still remember, kung babalikan natin yung previous slide natin dun sa activity. So, tinignan natin kung ito bang x squared plus 2x minus 1, kapag nakuha natin yung table of values, mapuprove kaya natin na quadratic function siya? So, yes. Kasi dito pa lang sa second differences, nag-equal na siya. So, ibig sabihin, yung example natin kanina, this is a quadratic function. This is really a quadratic function kasi na-prove niya dito sa second differences na equal sila. So, this is an example of quadratic function. Okay. Now, paano naman kapag graph? Paano tayo mag-graph ng quadratic function? So, the graph of a quadratic function is called a parabola. So, kanina nga, nagpakita tayo dun sa lesson, o pwede natin balikan yung lesson nito bago pwede nyong panoorin sa ating playlist. So, kapag nag-graph tayo ng quadratic function, the graph is always parabola. Okay? It is basically a curved shape opening upward or downward. So, mamaya malalaman natin kailan siya nagiging upward at downward. When you have a quadratic function in the form of ax squared, y is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c. Now, kailan siya upward at downward? If a is greater than 0, ibig sabihin, if your a o yung value ng a mo is greater than 0, ibig sabihin positive number or positive integers, then the graph opens upward. But, if your a is less than 0, meaning negative integer, then the graph opens downward. So, sa baba. Okay? Let's have an example. So, sketch the graph of f of x is equal to x squared minus 2x plus 3. So, dito naman ang gagawin natin, how are you going to show a quadratic function using graph? Okay? So, let's have first, step 1, complete the table. So, kapag nag-graph tayo, hindi tayo pwedeng mag-graph na lang basta-basta that you are going to plot points kung anong gusto nyo. Okay? So, kailangan meron tayong table of values para makuha natin yung ordered pair na ipaplot natin sa Cartesian plane. Okay? If you are familiar with the Cartesian plane. So, itong x natin, kung given yung x values natin, yun na ang gagamitin natin. Pero kung ikaw, kung gusto mong mag-test, pwede ka namang mag-assign ng any values of x. Okay? Pwede kang mag-assign. Pero kung given naman si X na, yun na ang gagamitin mo. So, mag-a-assign tayo ng values of X. So, meron ako ditong negative 3 hanggang positive 5. Kinuha ko ang Y values. So, ito ang nakuha natin. Now, step 2 natin is you are going to plot the points in a Cartesian plane. So, ayan, pinlot ko. So, from negative 3 to 18, negative 3, ito si negative 3, 18. Ayun siya, si A. And then, negative 2, 11. So, ito siya, si B. Negative 1, negative 1, ito si negative 1, 6. And then, this is 0, 4. 0, 3, rather. And then, this is positive 1, 2. So, ayan siya. Now, kung mapapansin nyo, ang graph ng quadratic equation natin ay symmetrical. Okay? Ano ba ibig sabihin ng symmetrical? Kumbaga, balance sila. Okay? Pantay siya from left and right. Okay? So, dito pa lang sa table of values, makikita na natin eh. Kasi ito oh, so ito yung pinakagitna natin, diba? Ito siya, 1, 2. Ito yun. And then, ito yung pinakagitna. Kung mapapansin nyo, pagdating dito, yung values niya sa taas at sa baba, yung ordered pair, ito siya. Pareho na. 3, 6, 11, 18. 3, 6, 11, 18. So, yun yung sinatawag nating symmetrical. Okay? Kaya pagka-plot ng points, ayan. And then, after natin mag-plot ng points, anong gagawin? Of course, i-coconnect natin ang mga plotted points natin. So, ayan na siya. So, as you can see, the graph of the quadratic function is parabola. But, remember, maglalagay tayo ng arrow dyan. Nakat lang kasi natin dito yung picture, okay? By the way, itong app na ginamit natin dito ay pwede kayong gumamit ng GeoGebra, okay? So, itong graph na to, kinat lang natin para mag-fit siya dito sa ating PowerPoint slide. So, meron niyang arrow dyan. Okay. So, kapag nag-graph tayo, eto siya. So, as you can see, symmetrical siya. Ito yung pinaka-gitna. So, pareho siya. Okay. Now, remember, bakit siya open sa port? Okay. Bakit siya open sa port? Balikan natin yung A. Eto. Diba our A here is positive 1. And positive 1 is greater than 0. Kung babalikan nyo yung explanation ko kanina, na kapag ang A natin is greater than 0, the graph, or yung graph ng quadratic function natin, o yung parabola, opens upward. So, kapag ang A natin ay greater than 0, your graph opens upward. Okay? So, since 1 yan, positive 1, so ang graph natin opens upward. Next. So, I have here negative x squared plus 2x minus 1. So, again, assign tayo ng values for x. Pero kung given na si x, yun ang gagamitin natin. So, nakuha ko na si y. Ito na si y. So, ipa-plot na natin ng points. So, plot the points on the Cartesian plane. So, ito I have negative 3, 16. So, ito yung negative 3 natin. 16, ayun. And then, negative 2. Negative 2, negative 9, and then 0, negative 1, ito si negative 1. Negative 1, negative 4. And then this is your 0, negative 1, this is your 1, 0. This is your, anong next? Positive 2, negative 1. And then positive 3, negative 4. Actually, continuous lang siya. Kasi nga sabi ko nga, ang graph ng parabola natin ay symmetrical. So, tingnan nyo dito. Ito siya, ito yung pinakagitna, okay? So, ito, negative 1, negative 4. So, ibig sabihin, itong kasunod nito ay negative 9, and then yung kasunod, negative 16. Continuous yan. So, kapag nag-graph tayo ng quadratic function, at ang graph natin ay parabola, continuous yan. Kaya kapag nag-graph tayo, may arrow yan lagi sa dulo. Ibig sabihin, tuloy-tuloy. Okay? Now, let us plot the points. So, we have, let us connect the points, rather. So, eto na siya. So, itutuloy mo yun. Hindi porket nandito yung point mo, hanggang dyan lang siya, hanggang dyan lang. Siyempre, kinat lang natin dito yung, yung pag-solve ng X and Y, yung table of values. Pero, pwede mo tong ituloy. So, maglagay ka pa dyan ng 4. Mag-substitute ka ng 4 dun sa X mo. Matutuloy mo yan. Kaya, ayan yung mga points na yan. Tuloy-tuloy yan. Alright? So, this is the graph of your quadratic function. Bakit siya opens downward? Kasi our A is negative 1. Diba? Sabi ko kanina, if your A is negative 1 or if your A is less than 0 and negative 1 is less than 0, the graph of the parabola opens downward. Ulitin ko, if your A is less than 0, since ang A natin dito ay negative 1 and negative 1 is less than 0, therefore the graph of the parabola opens downward. Pababa tayo. So dito pa lang makikita nyo na. Okay? So let us try. It's quiz time. Okay, the graph of a quadratic function is a smooth curve called. So I'm giving you 5 seconds. I hope you get 4 and 5. So 4 and above. Okay? So these are your choices. I'm giving you 5 seconds. Alright, so the answer is parabola. So always remember that the graph of a quadratic function is always parabola. Next. In a quadratic function in the form y is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c, if a is greater than 0, then the graph opens. These are your choices. Okay, it opens upward. So since positive ito, upward siya. Next. In a quadratic function in the form y is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c, if a is less than 0, then the graph opens. These are your choices. Alright, so the answer is downward. Downward because your a is less than 0, meaning negative ang value ng a natin dyan. So your graph or the graph of the parabola is downward. Next, identify the table that represents a quadratic function. So ulitin ko, kapag quadratic function, these are your choices. Alright, so kasabi ko nga kanina, kapag quadratic function, mag-i-equal ang difference niya sa second difference, okay? So, ang sagot natin dyan ay ito. Kasi kung kukunin mo ang difference nito, nag-equal na agad siya dun pa lang sa first difference. Hindi kagaya nito, sa first difference, kung kukunin mo siya, hindi pa siya equal. Sa second difference mo, makukuha yung equal value. So, therefore, this is your quadratic function. And the last, we have which graph best describe this table of values. So, I have here your table. So, alin kaya ang graph nito? These are your choices. Alright, so ang una mong titingnan dyan, since symmetrical ito, so 5, 11, dito na. So, hanapin mo yung may plotted point na 0, 3. Asan ang may 0, 3 dyan? Eto, so 0, 3. So, ayun siya. So, this, the correct answer is letter D. So, if you got 4 and 5, please comment down below your score. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned something. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell para updated kayo for more video tutorials. This is your guide in learning your math lessons, your Walmart channel.